Look who's joining us, the reigning Miss Universe, Demi-Leigh Nel-Peters.
Hi.
How you doing, girl?
I'm good. You have an absolutely beautiful city. It's my first time in Providence, and I've just had the best day.
Well, welcome to Providence. We're so glad that you're here.
Thank you.
I mean, you know, Miss Universe, Little Rhode Island, how often does that happen?
Well, as you know, Olivia's from here.
That's
so,
right.
I mean, it looks like it happens often.
Miss Universe 2012, I believe. We're referring to Miss Cranston, Olivia Culpo. Shout out to Olivia. We love her here.
Yeah.
Home state love.
Yes.
So I thought it would be fun, and I thought you might have your crown on. Is it a requirement? Do you have to wear it all the time?
No. I mean, there's a place and a time for everything, and it depends. So we tend to bring it out for just really special occasions. So it gets kind of heavy too.
Oh my gosh, I would probably get a headache all the time. I don't know how you do it.
You manage it. I mean, it's pretty special.
So we would love to play a little game with you.
Sure.
Play a little
round. Game.
A round called My First. So if I was to say to you, my first time I met a celebrity was?
I was 17 and I met the current Miss South Africa at the time, Melinda Bum, and we are actually very good friends now. After
simple
I won.
And
so
easy as that.
Yeah.
Piece of cake.
Yeah.
You got this game down. All right, so here we go. My first pageant ever was?
Was probably a school pageant in second grade that somebody nominated me for.
Second grade?
You know, Little Miss Butterfly, whatever. I don't even
was
remember.
Was that the title?
I really don't
the
know.
The title holder of Little Miss Butterfly.
Oh, no, I didn't even win. I don't think I even placed. No.
No. Well, you showed them, girl. You take that, whoever
come
was
back.
Miss Butterfly then. Look at you now. All right, my first celebrity crush was?
I've honestly never had a celebrity crush.
Never?
No.
How about fangirling over a celebrity? Like, I fangirled over J-Lo last night at the Video Music Awards.
I did too.
Okay.
I really did too. I saw her perform live for the first time earlier this year at the Super Bowl.
No way.
One of the events. So that was a total girl crush moment, yes.
Awesome.
And then even little Beyonce.
All right, so Queen B.
Queen B.
So Queen Universe and Queen B. My first Miss Universe appearance was?
A week after I won.
Yeah.
Well, no, it was the day after I won. I was on the morning after I won, very early. How can I forget that on Good Morning America?
Doing all kinds of press.
Yes, yes. So that was definitely, and then literally 5 days after I left for my first international trip to the Philippines. So that was very special. Philippines have a very special place in my heart, and I just love all their support.
All right, how about a fun one? My first big purchase was?
I bought a pair of heels this year.
What kind?
They have red bottoms.
Oh, the red bottoms, the Louboutins maybe, perhaps?
I don't know. It took me like 2 months to prepare for that.
2 months to prepare. Did you even want to wear them afterwards? It's now I can't ruin them.
Yeah, that's so true. That's very true. You don't want to ruin them.
I know. Something that good. My first self-defense class was?
Was 3 months before I was in a carjack incident. So it was in March last year, 2017.
Which is unreal to me.
I know. And I can honestly just testify on how much that is helped me to get out of that situation, and that's kind of how Unbreakable was born.
So we should say you're on the Unbreakable tour. You're on the road. Your first stop is here in Providence,
yes.
Correct?
How exciting.
Yep. So you have a speaking engagement coming up later on today.
I do.
Whole platform is about self-defense, empowering women. Tell us a little bit about that.
So Unbreakable started really by an accident. I was on my way to an event in June last year in South Africa, and as the reigning Miss South Africa, I stopped at a red traffic light. My car was surrounded by five armed men.
How terrifying.
It really was, and thank goodness I was alone in the car at the time, so nobody else's life was in danger. They, you know, surrounded the car. I immediately surrendered, got out. I had three guns pointing to my head at the same time. I managed to get away by punching one of the guys in their throat, and that I knew I had to create a window of opportunity to get away, and all I kept hearing was the empowerment course I did that taught me never go to the second destination. You know, they taught me that punching somebody in the throat can be lethal, to create a window of opportunity, to surrender. I did all those things and I managed to escape unharmed, and that is how Unbreakable was born. But I think Unbreakable,
so fierce, so strong, because in the moment I feel like I would have froze.
I mean, that's fight, flight, or freeze. That's the three things, the three options we usually have. And I wanted to flee. I couldn't. So my other option was to fight. I luckily didn't freeze. But I guess it's different for everyone. But I think the thing that I realized was, if you have a little bit of knowledge, mm-hmm. it's way easier to think through something, to take action, when you at least have a little voice in your head, or those, you know, those little things you remember. It's like when your mom...
So inspiring and so strong.
Well, thank you.
It really is. And that's why you do what you do. How about my first night living in New York City was...
My group of my friends and my parents actually joined me in New York City after the pageant. They just changed their flight tickets and came straight there. They helped me move in and into my new apartment. We went out to Times Square, had a big slice of New York cheesecake, and
very touristy.
Tried to soak it all in.
That's amazing, because you are from South Africa.
Yes.
Are you the first Miss Universe to hold the title from South Africa?
I'm actually not. Margaret Gardner won the title. Okay. She was the first Miss Universe from South Africa.
Amazing.
And there was about a 40-year gap, a 39-year gap in between.
Long time coming, long overdue.
Yes, yes.
We love that. How about my first cheat meal after Miss Universe was?
Well, definitely the cheesecake.
New York cheesecake, that's a good choice. That's a good one. My first time wearing the crown was...
Well, the night of the pageant.
How'd you feel?
So, I mean, it's just such a surreal moment. It's such a dream come true, and you kind of have to experience it for yourself, but it was very enchanting.
We'll wrap with this. My first time in Rhode Island was?
Really memorable. Really memorable.
How about you be very Rhode Island right now and you say to the camera, wicked awesome. Go ahead.
Wicked awesome.
There you go. That's it. The reigning Miss Universe, Demi-Leigh, thank you so much for spending time with 92 Pro FM today.
Thank you for having me. Is that something you guys say around here? Wicked awesome?
Wicked awesome.
All right. Okay, now I know.
That's it. She's got it.